Good evening. Welcome to Grandma's Attic Music Review. Ah, fall is here, isn't it? Forecast is snow, by the way, sometime in the next 3 months. So, that being said, there's a wonderful way to spend your Saturday snow-filled evenings. From now on, if you tune in on Saturday evening at 10 o'clock, you'll be able to see this show. I believe that we'll be running two shows back to back, coming up one of these weekends. I'm not sure which one, but when we do, you'll know it because it will say so. So today, I have what I call the produce that happens when you get to do things like judge blues competitions. I have been asked several times now to judge the Connecticut Blues Society Blues Competition, which sends our musicians down to Memphis for the International Blues Challenge. And the solo duo challenge is a little different than the band challenge. And these two gentlemen participated and they just blew me away. I did the drop jaw thing and I was really happy to listen to them play. I was a little disappointed in the outcome, but that's okay. So anyway, I hope that you'll enjoy their music. I think that if you dig the blues, you're going to dig what they do. And sit back and enjoy Chris and Jory.
Thank you. How's it going? I'm Chris. This is Jory to my left here.
This is what we've decided that we wanted to do. This is our duo stuff, and we hope you like it.
Wandering gypsy, I could be poor like a foul water lord. I could be first man or I could come last. It's not who breaks the ribbon, boy, it's how you get across. I could bleed red, blue, black and white, sunset, darkest that night, boy, brightest that night.
Da 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 da
be a sleeping man or I can be awake. I can be alive or be the walking dead. I can be ignorant or I can be informed. I can live my life, man, or I can be led. I can be anything I put my mind to, man. All I gotta do is give myself half a chance. I can bring love back into my life. Share it with the world if I got some talent. So I'm singing la da 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 da.
Thank you.
That was Zebra by John Butler Trio. We were both a pretty big fan of John Butler, and that was one of the songs that just kind of clicked with both of us, and we really liked it and just decided that this is the song that we should probably go with by him. Next, we're going to do another electric song, and we're going to do Whipping Post by the Allman Brothers.
Nice.
Such a fool. I had to stand by and see you, baby, off for loving you. I drown myself in sorrow, but look at what you've done. Oh, nothing seemed to change. Bad times stay the same. Now I can't run. Sometimes I feel
Thank you very much. As much as we love jamming like that, we're going to do a little bit of an acoustic show for you now. So Chris and I have been jamming together for, man, about 3 or 4 months now. We were in a band a little while ago, and somehow we managed to find ourselves here. And I gotta say, it's quite refreshing to be doing something like this. And we hope you enjoy what we're about to do as much as we've been in the last few months. Thank you. This next song is another one very near and dear to me. This one is a song by John Mayer, but this is not one that you're exactly going to hear on any of his studio albums. This is the kind of song that gets released way after that the record company doesn't exactly get to tell him what to write anymore, and he gets to just kind of do what he wants. And these are some of the best words I think he's ever written in a song.
Not sure that I really ever could hold on to your hotel key in your bedroom neighborhood. Me sleepwalking in Hollywood. So I am gonna steer clear. Burn up in your atmosphere. So I am gonna steer clear. Die if I saw you. Die if I didn't see you there. On the boulevard at night, without your voice to tell me I love you, take it right. Send them the two is the loneliest side. Burn up in your atmosphere. So I am gonna steer clear of life. I saw you. I'd die if I didn't see you. So I am gonna steer clear. Oh yeah. I would burn up in your atmosphere. So I am gonna steer clear of life. If I saw you, I'd die if I didn't see you there. See you there. Think I'm gonna stay in the grave. Think I'm gonna stay to stay.
lights, they say never mind. The canyon lines, they say never mind. The sunset says we see this all the time. Never mind, never you mind.
Alright, we've got one more for you here. This is perhaps the one most near and dear to both of our hearts.
This is a song by Dave Matthews. I've been a huge Dave Matthews fan for a long time, and showed Jory, who was into it a little bit, and I got him hooked on a couple of songs, and I knew how to play this one, started showing him a little bit. And then next thing we know, we start jamming it, and it just sounds incredible. So that is why we decided to do it today.
It is the tune-up song. You got it. You can't have a show without a tune-up song. Thank you.
I wanna believe in Jesus. Baby, when I get home, I wanna believe, I wanna believe,
Thank you.
Hey guys, buddy, come over and join me. While the guys are getting unhooked and hooked up, let me just tell about some things that are going on. If you don't know, the Eastern Connecticut Symphony Orchestra is in full swing by now, and they do a show a month, except for the month of December, so you still have time to get tickets to the rest of the season. They have a new executive director, and he will be with us in December to talk about his plans for the jewel of New London, the Eastern Connecticut Symphony Orchestra, and I'm looking forward to that. We also have businesses downtown that are thriving. There's a yoga shop, Bliss Yoga, on State Street.
Bliss Works.
I have to get straightened out often. And they're a great place to go and learn about yoga. And, of course, Cobalt Blue and the Eyeglass Lass and the Hive Shop. Just check out your local businesses. Remember, it's important to shop local. Hi, guys. That was fun.
That was a lot of fun.
Yeah, yeah. You guys love to play music. I can see it in your faces. Where does your love of music come from? Why don't you, Jory, why don't you answer that first?
Man, from really, really young. I just grew up in a musical family. My dad was always playing music. And he was kind of, he never picked one style. He just kind of, he threw me into every style he possibly could and was like, here, it's music. You got to listen to everything. And then as I got older, I started to kind of pick my own styles and stuff. But now it's like I can just, because of that, I can get into any kind of music and just kind of feel it no matter what it is.
Yeah, I think that people with eclectic taste, just fare better in the long run anyway. How about you, Chris?
Same thing. I remember I got my first drum set third grade at Christmas. I remember I ran out to the garage. It was the happiest moment ever. And I was just a little kid. My dad started guitar right at the same time. So we were constantly kind of fueling each other. He'd progress on guitar while I'd be progressing on drums or bass or just picking up everything that I could. And he was real big into like Grateful Dead and Phil Lesh and very jam band just going off. So ever since I can remember, for the longest time, I was playing with guys doing 30-minute instrumentals, 30-minute jams.
We're having mic problems. That's okay. So anyway, you both grew up with parents that were musical. Was your first instrument a guitar? Or have you always just played guitar?
Yeah, it was guitar. I mean, I was like every other kid. I got guitars as a present and never really picked it up until later, you know.
Were you in a band in high school?
Oh, definitely. Yeah, I've been in a band. I haven't not been in a band since I was 12, and I'm 18.
Nice. Yeah. So you have experience being on stage. But wasn't this blues competition kind of the first time you guys really went out and competed in the blues category?
In the blues category, yes. Definitely, we've done competitions before of the like, but we've never done just blues. I started out as just blues, doing Black Eyed Sally's open mics and Hungry Tiger open mics and stuff like that. But you know, it's evolved, and we're kind of getting back to where I started.
Right, the blues are just definitely kind of the basis for rock and roll, anyway. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. And you take the jazz and the blues, and it's just without American music. There wouldn't be any rock and roll. That's all I can say. You know, the bass goes back that far. Where do you guys see yourselves? You didn't win this competition, except that you won in my eyes, and so you got to come here. So that's a good thing. Where do you guys see yourselves going with this duo?
I mean, we'd like to obviously progress as much as we can, and
put it up here.
We'd like to progress as much as we can, and we'd like trying new things. You know, we did that blues contest, and it was music that, at least, C said he played for a while. It was at least music that I wasn't too familiar with. I wasn't too familiar with the blues that much, but then we picked it up. We had a lot of fun playing it, and, I mean, we mesh really, really well together. So we're just kind of constantly trying new songs. If we hear a song, we'll try it, and then we kind of just keep our styles going. And
so if you keep practicing the blues, you can come back for next year's duo challenge and win.
That'd be ideal.
Yeah, that'd be the best.
So Memphis and Nashville are kind of a little ways away, but do you have any plans to go down there and pick up any of the stylings and things that happen down south like that?
Oh yeah.
At some point, yeah.
It's kind of just the want to be not in the music scene you grew up in almost. There's kind of always that want, just like what else is out there? And there's so many, and that's just one. And yeah, that's definitely one that we'd want to go to.
Right, well, if you go down to Nashville or Memphis, what you'll see is at this point, everybody's playing a little bit of everything. Mm-hmm. But of course, the blues are huge, huge. And when you look at the different stylings of just the blues, you've got Chicago blues, Memphis blues, and LA blues, and oh my gosh, it just goes so far. I would love to see you guys grab a hold of some of the old unpatented stuff that's public domain and look at how they did that stuff. I can see both of you doing really old blues, the acoustic stuff, and really getting into it. I watched your faces, and you guys are so into what you're doing, and you absorb each other's karma so well that it would be nice to see what you did with public domain stuff that you really can own. You can really turn it into your own stuff. It would be great to see you do that. Let's talk a little bit about just a little bit of other things. What do you guys do when you're not playing music? Because obviously you're not making a living making music.
Unfortunately not.
None of us do.
Yeah. I'm a restaurant server.
Is
what I do.
Keeps you going, right?
Yeah, exactly. I can't complain. Constantly talking to people made me very, very outgoing.
Yeah.
And it's a good job. I'm happy with it.
Nice. Well, and it leaves you open to really pursue your career in music.
Yeah, that, because you could take restaurant server anywhere.
Yeah, you can.
You can go anywhere.
I'm a full-time UConn student in
business. Nice. Nice. I have some other musicians in my thing. I don't know what you call my thing.
The pool of musicians.
In my stable? Oh, I think that's a little, well, no, not in my, that's kinky. They go to UConn. The Maxwell brothers are up there, and if you get a chance to see them, they're both doing, I know that Ian Maxwell is doing a lot with the acoustic stuff up there. Are you majoring in music?
I'm majoring in business marketing. So.
Okay. So that you can run your band.
Exactly, yeah.
The manager's in the band. We're good.
Believe me, if you can manage the band by yourself and do all your own bookings and keep that money just between the two of you, you're going to make more money than if you have to pay me. Just let you know. I charge a lot. No, I don't. So that's good. When do you graduate?
I'm a freshman, so yeah, 4 years from now.
I didn't realize you were that young. Nice. Girls, he's young. So neither one of you are supporting families. You're both really new at this duo thing. Do you have any plans to pull anybody else into this, or do you really like just working together alone?
It's been just a chaotic past couple of months with everything that's gone on with the band that we were in breaking up, and then we did the blues contest, and then you asked us to come on the show, which we were super stoked about, and then we had a guitarist come to us and ask if we can help him for a show. We have a Battle of the Bands coming up.
When is the Battle of the Bands?
November 14th.
Yeah, it's a Saturday.
Where is that?
Webster Underground. We've got tickets, and it's our last gig as Bridge Out.
Yeah, that was the band that we were in that broke up.
Slightly different lineup than the original, but it's the last gig as Bridge Out. You can go check out Bridge Out and get tickets and all that fun stuff.
But yeah, so we've been doing all that, and I think. Both of us, I'm not speaking for Jory here, but I think both of us ideally would like to see ourselves back in a band.
Yeah.
We liked that a lot, and it's just, I feel like it's more room for opportunity, almost.
Really?
Yes and no. It depends on location, I guess. I feel like in Connecticut, duo would take us a very long way. I feel like if we went somewhere else that was more kind of live band music oriented, I'd be a little different.
Yeah, like some horns or something like that sort of direction.
Yeah.
Nice.
I've always been attached to a trio, though, so I wouldn't want anything really more than that, other than that and horns.
You like that? You like that small? I like the fact that you guys are small. I like what you do with your drum kit and your rhythm section. Mm-hmm. I think that's pretty unique. There's only one other duo I know that kind of does that. And actually, they're going to be on my show next week. But it's still, it's a unique way of keeping it simple and still putting a backbeat in there. I enjoyed that a lot. So I lost my question. It just went there. Let me pause for the cause. Okay, so you don't mind thinking about getting into a band. You have the Battle of the Bands coming up on the 14th.
14th, yep.
Of November. And do you have anything else planned for the holidays, or are you just kind of sitting back and
Yeah, right now we're still just kind of playing catch up.
Yeah, I mean, we didn't even know where we were at, and then we just got all these projects. We're like, well, you know what? Let's go.
Yeah, it was one day, we're not in a band anymore. We should work on that. We should find a drummer. And then it was blues contest, and yeah, it was just a whole bunch of stuff.
But you understand that now that you've done the show, you're going to get more requests, right?
Oh yeah, and we're absolutely all for the duo.
We're not going to lose the duo. We just would like to be involved in something more, like on top of it, almost.
All right.
Yeah.
With horns, out there that you're interested in some horns. So horn guys,
any horn players out there?
Here they are. They're all set. That's a good thing. That's a nice way of doing things. You're in business. You're studying business. If you don't make it musically, do you plan to own a business, or is your only goal to have the business background so that you can do something with your music?
It was part of it, like just in case sort of thing. But yeah, I probably, if it wasn't for music, I wouldn't have gone for business. I would have gone for probably something like science-y or something like that. But yeah, it was just, I've got all intentions of trying to make it. So I mean, I'm going to do everything I can to do it and kind of deal with when it doesn't happen, if that happens.
Okay.
Cross that bridge when it gets there.
Right. Now, are your parents still playing music?
My family doesn't play any music. I'm the only one.
Wow. That's kind of weird.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, especially since you said you came up in a musical household.
We listened to a lot of music. Not a lot of playing, but there was always music playing. They were always showing me new stuff.
Nice. And are you still playing with your dad at all?
Occasionally. That Martin that I was actually playing is his. Like, I was fortunate enough to have him let me borrow it for this. He picks it up from time to time, and he's bugging me to write him some bass lines that he can jam to, and I've been meaning to get to it. But he occasionally, not as much as he used to play, but.
So I just heard you use the term write a bass line. Are you writing any music, the two of you, or are you writing any songs at all?
We haven't written together yet, but we've both written.
We each have tons of songs, yeah. Like bits and pieces of songs that we want to eventually merge together and actually sit down and write them.
Before he was in Bridge Out, we got to go and record an album, so we wrote enough to do that with Bridge Out. So we'll get to it. It wasn't quite time yet. We needed to focus on, you know.
Getting ready for this gig.
Yeah and still right. if we're doing duo stuff, still kind of vibing and figuring out what songs we like to play, you know, what kind of style, how our jams will go, if we decide we want to write jammy songs or if we want to just write a pop song.
Like, yeah. There's pop songs and there's jam songs.
Yeah.
Do you think that jam bands are coming back? Or do you think that they've just kind of been hiding out and now are becoming more prominent?
I mean, I think it's a little bit of both. You know, like you have your big main ones. You have Dave Matthews Band, who's still selling out every show. You got Fish, who's doing 3-day tours in Vegas, like a three-day weekend. Widespread Panic, I'm sure, is still out there doing his String Cheese Incident, all those guys.
But locally, we have at least 3 jam bands that I can think of right off the top of my head, and that's Someone You Can X-Ray, Jeremiah Hazed, and the Something Kazoo Family Band. Now, those three, I don't know if you've heard of any of them, but
Bridge
they're
did
all
a gig
three.
With
all three are really good jam bands, and they're really starting to go places, especially Someone You Can X-Ray. They're they're going all over the place. They're playing all the time. They're booked solid for the rest of the year. And you guys are kind of jammy, too, and you did that Dave Matthews song, and that was real jammy. Do you think that jam music is coming back in a bigger way? Do you think it's going to do what the Dead did eventually?
I think it's just the fact that jam band music, the first time you hear it, or for at least the first time I heard it, it's kind of like this whole new world. Like, mm-hmm. it's different than any other music I had heard. So for a generation or a time where most of the music around is just so different, I think the first time you hear a jam band, which most of the people haven't, it's like just a whole new experience. So I think it could make a comeback just because we're so not used to it right now.
Right.
And I think that if it makes as much of an impact as I think it can, yeah, people are going to like it.
Right. Well, when I look at the bands that were big back when the Dead started, they were so different. Mm-hmm. Big Brother and the Holding Company and Grateful Dead, they hung out together. And they were so different. Okay, we have to close. You guys have to go take us out with a song. Quick question. If you're alone on a desert island and you can pick one thing to bring with you, would it be a record player, a guitar, or another human?
Oh, boy. That would have to be a guitar.
That
okay. would probably have
what
to
about
be a
you,
guitar.
Chris?
Yeah, it'd probably have to be a guitar. I'd probably get annoyed with another human.
I think we spend more
human.
Time playing music than we do even talking to each other.
All right. Go take us out. Go take us out with a song. Thank you guys so much for coming on.
Thank
the
you.
Yeah, this while the guys great. Are getting back set up, let me remind you, the Hygienic Art has a really great show down at it called Shutter. The F stops here. And it's photography. So check that out. There's so much going on in downtown New London. There's so many different shows going on. If you're sitting at home bored, other than watching my show, then you're really not checking out what we have in this little jewel of a city. Shop local, support local acts, support local stuff, and come back next week. Thank you so much for watching Grandma's Attic Music Review. Bye-bye. See you next week. God bless.